The war in Iraq is a battle fought thousands of miles from the United States. It is a reality that most of us can escape by just turning off our televisions. Most Americans will never see a tank, never see a battle wound, and never see the consequences of combat up close and personal. But for the people of Iraq, the threat of being caught in the crossfire is a constant fear. There is terror in just going to the store or even walking home from school. They live in fear that around any corner, tragedy may strike. For 10-year-old Hashim Zarif, his fear becomes a reality when he and his family take a trip to the market. On their drive, they unknowingly pass a parked car that is rigged with explosives. In that instant, the car explodes. They are struck by an IED, an improvised explosive device, meant for someone else.
لكن ابني هذا المسكين الصغير هو اللي تعرض اكثر شيء مثل ما تعرفون الى جانب الايمن كسر الجمجمه مالته والشظايا دخلت بالدماغ وخضع الى عده والجانب الاخر الى حروق من الدرجه الثانيه واللي سببت له عدم حركه الاطراف اليمنى الايد والرجل.
Hashim is taken to a local hospital where shrapnel and bone are removed from his brain. He lies in a coma for 55 days. With part of his skull missing, only a layer of skin protects his brain. After more than 2 months in the hospital, he returns to daily life in Iraq with just a hat protecting his wound. But soon after Hashim's return, Zahra notices fluid leaking from her son's head. Hashim is brought to the attention of doctors in the green zone, who immediately take him under their care. But surgery after surgery, nothing stops the cranial fluid from leaking. With limited resources, the American military doctors seek more help.
أنا فتح لنا باب اللي تعرفنا على منظمة اللي ترأسها أمل النجار.
Children of War Foundation has the means to transport, identify, and medically treat children that have sustained devastating injuries as a result of war or civil conflict.
Through Mending Kids International and Children of War Foundation, work begins to try and get Hashim to the U.S. for reconstructive surgery. Their search leads them to Children's Hospital Los Angeles and its world-renowned craniofacial team.
The surgeons in Iraq, they were concerned that with exposed brain, meningitis, intracranial abscess, or simple trauma to that area would most certainly lead to a devastating injury, if not to death. So the concern is really to save his life.
Dr. Jeffrey Hammoudeh assembles a team of esteemed surgeons willing to take on Hashim's critical case.
What we do in the next few weeks can make his life, can change the course of his life for the better for the next 80 years. And I think the opportunity to do that, for me, I couldn't pass that by.
The way I try to look at it is, what can I do to help the child? And we do everything we can to help the children.
With the team of surgeons now in place, Dr. Hammoudeh gives the green light for Hashim to come to Children's Hospital, Los Angeles. After a grueling 13-hour car ride through the desert, then days of fighting for visas in Jordan, Zahra and Hashim say goodbye to Hashim's father and board a plane for Los Angeles.
When he got here, I was like, all right, they got him here, which at that point now put him in our hands. First thing that we did when he got here, is we sent them for a CAT scan, a craniofacial CT, so we could look at the injury to the brain, to the skull, and come up with a treatment plan.
The team at Children's Hospital determines that Hashim's condition is worse than they expected. Contrary to previous reports from Iraq, Hashim's brain is not clear of debris. The leaking cranial fluid is an infection caused by a piece of bone still lodged inside his brain. Dr. Hammoudeh changes his original plan of treatment. Instead of just covering the missing piece of Hashim's skull, doctors must first remove the bone fragment that is causing the potentially fatal infection. Just a week after Hashim arrives in Los Angeles, he is taken to the OR for life-saving surgery. Doctors Hammoudeh and Urata carefully remove the infected skin that covers Hashim's wound. Then, Dr. McComb very cautiously attempts to retrieve the infected bone fragment that is lodged inside Hashim's brain. One wrong move could leave Hashim paralyzed. As her child's life lies in the hands of American doctors, all Zahra can do is wait and pray.
كنت خايفة لتكون العملية فاشلة وأرجع ابني إلى العراق على كرسي متحرك أو يعني أو تسوء حالته.
Four and a half hours later, Zahra's prayers are answered. Doctors have successfully removed the infected bone fragment. Hashim is moved to the ICU for recovery and observation.
After the operation, Dr. McComb came out and explained what he did, and Zahra just had this look on her face like it was the most happiest time in her life. She thanked everybody and she cried. It was a good day. It was a good day.
Shortly after surgery, Hashim begins physical therapy to regain some of the movement he lost from the blast. Hashim and Zahra settle in, making Children's Hospital their new home.
She told me that it had been the most amazing hospital she had ever been to. Hashim said it was like a playground. It was so colorful and there were so many toys and so many things to do and everyone was so nice to him.
ما تلرأي كل مرتاح على هاي المستشفى الحلوة كلها حلوة الدكتور يساعدني المعلمة كل شيء أكو حتى مدرسة أكو يعلموني كل شيء أكو.
I think with a child from a war zone, it makes you one, you're humbled, right? And it really makes you appreciate what we have here.
Although Hashim's mother is constantly by his side, the nurses are his newest and most trusted caregivers. For one nurse, her relationship with Hashim grows closer every day.
I first went into the room and he had this huge smile on his face and he had this nasty looking Halloween mask right next to him on the bed. And he put it on his face and he just gave me a thumbs up sign and I was like, oh, I can work with this kid.
Despite the language barrier, Hashim and Allyson have no problem communicating with each other.
We do a lot of facial gestures, like When I first came in, we were doing ow for pain, like a really bad face. But now I'm starting to learn a little bit of Arabic, very little. And so I learned the word alam for pain. So now we use the word alam, and he says no.
Although Hashim has more operations ahead, Zahra's visa is about to expire, so she must return to Iraq and leave her son in the care of her newfound friends.
يعني حتى يعني هاي الأيام اللي ما أبات وياها ويا هاشم أكون مرتاحة بالبيت لأن عايفته يم أناس يعني الممرضات ما يعوفوا
عادي هي اسمها ماما لازم وياني هتشي ما عادي مرات ما أبيده بس هتشي
يعني لو مهما تكلمت أو مهما شكرت فما راح يكفي يعني لكل الكادر إلى جميع الأصدقاء اللي تعرفت عليهم لو قد ما شكرتهم فما راح يوفي لأن يعني لأن شعور أم وتأذت بابنها وانصدمت بنفس الوقت لكن القدر فرحها من جديد.
In the next few months, Hashim will undergo two more surgeries, one to install a metal plate for protection, and another to have new skin grafted to the burnt side of his head. Then, once completely recovered, he will go home.
If part of our goal is to help rebuild Iraq, why not invest in their future? And this is a major investment in the future of Iraq.
The war is so distant from where we are right here. It doesn't quite seem real, even though politicians give us all these statistics, Hashim is a face to put to that. And that is a very powerful thing to think about.
The opportunity to reconstruct a child's life, if you will, to try and erase, to the best of our abilities, a really bad memory that should never have occurred to a young, innocent child. I think that's our reward.
I think there's a reason why his life was spared, and I think he'll go on to tell people that complete strangers, they offered him a chance at a happier life, a longer life, and I think with that, he'll touch people's lives.
Our mission in this hospital is to reach out to children, whether they're white, brown, black, doesn't matter their race, religion, whether they can afford care or they can't.
I should go home, good home. I don't want to say, I'm Iraqiin saada awwal marra ani ba'den lissa yasaadun atfal waya Iraqiin.
Hashim will go back to Iraq, where he will resume the childhood that was threatened by war, but is now restored with the help of total strangers who reached out to him over 7,500 miles away.